Hi. Okay. Right. Well, this is me. I am Naomi, otherwise known as at Real Fertile. I work with Sally, alongside Sally, and I run the fertility yoga teacher training with Sally. Hi, Nick. So I'm just taking over for Sally today. She's still a little bit sore. Hello, everyone. Oh, nice to see people popping on. Hi. I thought I was going to be here all on my own. That's cool. Great to see you. So yeah, Sally's not feeling so great, so I'm just jumping on today to do a little class for you. Who else is feeling the effects of this full moon? It's a bit of a powerful one, this one, with the whole kind of Scorpio influence in. It's quite emotional, quite intense. So we're going to keep it pretty kind, pretty gentle, but we're going to look at what we can release today. So yeah, if there's anything on your mind that you feel should you'd like to kind of let go of, bring it into practice today. So I guess we'll just get started. Great stuff. See you on the mat. I'm just going to grab a box on because I know my lower back's a little bit tight today. So if that's what you'd like as well, please do. I hope you can hear me okay. I'm not used to recording on my phone, so I'll project my voice out, but hopefully it's all good. So let's just sit nice and comfortably on our mat in our space and just take a moment to arrive. As I say, it's pretty emotional at the moment, quite a lot of turmoil. We're just starting to get used to integrating back into the world, and that in itself can bring up a lot of emotions that we didn't really know were there. So let's just get ourselves comfortably seated. Take a couple of breaths. Sigh out through the mouth. One more like that. Hi to everyone who's jumped on. We're just going to breathe in, bring our hands above our head, and breathe out. Hands down to heart in prayer. Breathe in. Breathe out, hands down to heart. One more time, breathe in. Really stretch out. Hands together above head. Breathe out down to heart. Wonderful. We're just going to raise our arms up in cactus arms. Really open up that heart. Breathe in. And as we breathe out, we'll bring our hands down into Yoni Mudra. Connecting with the powerhouse. It is our womb space. Breathing in. Our arms are going up. And breathing out. Hands back down, Yoni Mudra. So just practicing being kind to ourselves. Opening up to what the universe has in store for us. And one more. Hands down. Just going to take our left hand down to our left side and reach up with our right arm. Really spread those fingers out, just stretch on over. Feel the space just opening up all the way down your side. Take a big breath in and out. Over to the other side. Stretch it. Oh. And let's just flow from side to side for just a moment. So when I remember, which is not always, I have to say, I do try, and if I'm doing a practice involved with the moon, I do try and start on my left side, because the left side of us is energetically attached to the moon. So if we can remember, that's great. If not, it's also cool. I'm quite terrible with my lefts and rights, so I'm hoping I'll get it okay for you today. Bring our arms down by our sides. We're taking our legs out as wide as is comfortable for you. I'm just going to remove my block. So toes pointing up to the ceiling. Okay, we're going to bring our hands round in Kali Mudra. So that's that. So four fingers, index fingers together, thumbs gripping round, rest of our fingers like tightly there. Bring our arms out in front and we're just going to stir the pot. It's not an attractive name, but oh, it feels so good on the back. So we're just thinking about all those things that we want to release at the moment. What do we want to let go of at this time? The full moon is a perfect time to be letting go of things that don't serve us anymore. It may be things that you brought in with your intentions at the beginning of the month in the new moon. Maybe things that, you know, just kind of becoming apparent now. I'm going to go back in the other direction. Really stretch on out. So I'm exhaling as I'm bringing my hands towards me. Inhaling as I'm reaching out. One more in this direction. I'm going to bring my legs across in kind of mermaid leg position. So I've got front leg going across, back leg going out. Okay, we're sitting up tall. So we're going to place our, so I've got my, see, lefts and rights gone already. Sorry about this. I have got my right leg out to the side, so I'm going to put my left hand down and I'm going to push myself up, raise my right hand up to the sky, and just stretch on out. Really feel yourself open. We're opening to let go. Bring yourself back down and we're just going to twist round to the direction of our back leg. Breathing in nice and tall, letting go with every breath. Coming back round to the front, switching our legs to the other side, nice and tall. Every breath, we're breathing in the possibility of new. Every exhale, we're just letting go. Hand down by the side. We're going to raise that left arm to the sky now. Press those hips forward. Feel that wonderful opening in the front of the body. Fantastic. Okay, bring ourselves back down. We're just going to, again, going to twist round towards our back foot. These are nice open twists, so they're fine for anybody at any time of their menstrual cycle. Fantastic. Okay, so now we're just going to come a little Baddha Konasana just for a moment. Stretch up tall. And if you want to just fold forward, just feeling that opening in the inner thighs. It's nice as well as if it's available to you. And just open up the soles of your feet. And just breathe down into the space. Bring those legs back together. Just gonna swing them round, hands out in front. And I'm just gonna turn the other way. You stay where you are. Just going to keep our knees relatively wide, arms out, stretch a little way in front of you. Okay, fingers nice and wide. We're going to sit back to our heels. Feel that stretch all the way down your back. Really get it into that lumbar spine. And then we're going to swoop forward with our in breath, our out breath, curving around, really stretching into that lower back gently as we kind of ease down. Breathing in, coming forward, Breathing out, swooping back. Spread those fingers wide, keeping yourself open. Let's do one more. Just rest back in your child's pose for a moment. Wide-kneed child's pose, just rest on back. We're staying open, we're keeping those arms active, we're keeping the fingers active on the floor. Just move the arms on over to the left-hand side. So we're having a stretch in a kind of banana shape over to the left. Feeling that stretch down the right side of the body. Take your arms back to center. And then move them on over to the right. Feeling that stretch down the left-hand side of your body. Wonderful. Bring yourself up to your knees. We're going to tuck our toes under. And if you need to adjust your feet at any time, do. I'm going to keep my knees soft and just gently roll on up. Great. So as we're up, we're going to take our arms out wide, meeting hands at the top, down to our third eye, down to our heart. So as we breathe in, our arms raise to the sky, breathe out, our prayer pose down to our third eye, down to our heart. Breathing in, gathering the energy up. Breathing out, hands to third eye. Breathing in, hands to heart. Breathe out. Breathing in, gather the energy. Breathing out, hands to third eye. Breathing in, hands to heart. Breathe out. Breathing in, hands to heavens. That's nice, isn't it? Hands to the heaven. Breathing out, hands to third eye. Breathing in, hands to our heart. So we're trying to breathe in that openness and breathe out. The last time. And as we breathe out this time, we're going to swoop down. Let it go. Breathe in, come up. Let go of what's no longer serving you. Come on. Big sigh out. And one more. Hands back to prayer pose. How do you feel? How do you feel having let go of what no longer serves? Letting go with that full moon. Feeling open to new possibilities because you are letting go. Soften your knees slightly. Just come down into a forward fold. Just gently pedal your legs out one by one. If your hamstrings or lower back feel a bit tight, a bit restricted with all the emotions that are flying about at the moment. We're going to walk our hands forward into a downward facing dog. Feel free to adjust your hands, your feet, wherever's most comfortable with you, okay? So raising our hips up to the sky, we can pedal out our legs. Okay, then we're going to take that left leg, bend it at the knee, and just open up that hip. So we're sending that foot backwards, opening up the hip. Let's take a nice deep breath here. and plant that foot back down to the floor. If you're feeling like you need a little rest, you'd rather not be in downward dog right now, just go down into child's pose. Then we're going to do the same on the other side, okay? So we're going to raise that right heel up to the sky and swing our leg over, opening up that hip. Bring it down, your foot down, that is. Okay, lower your knees to the floor. Touch your toes, keep your knees wide. And just stretch on out in child's pose. Plant your forehead to the floor. Feel that connection with the earth. Know that this is a safe space where you can feel secure enough to let things go if you need to. So from our child's pose, we're just going to raise up into down dog again. Okay, this time we're going to take our left leg up, but we're going to bring our knee forward, coming down into pigeon pose. Okay. If you have sore knees, make sure that you keep your heel pretty close to your thigh. Okay, so don't bring your shin out too much and cause any twisting on the knee. Okay. So you can stay up high on your fingertips if we want to get a bit more into it. Just lower down. Front body over that front leg, whichever feels the best for you today. Just be aware of what's coming up right now. It's a great one for getting into the psoas and into the emotions. Pigeon pose, you either love it or hate it. It is a great one for releasing stuck emotions. Okay, and if you're folded on over, just gently bring your body back up again. Press it, we're tucking our toes under our back leg, pressing down in our hands, coming back up into downward dog. Just going to do the same on the other side, okay? So we're going to bring up our right leg. Knee to wrist, or back in your pigeon pose. So again, you can stay up high, or you can bring yourself down over that leg, over that foreleg. Foreleg? Are we horses? Front leg, sorry. And just let yourself really feel where you are in this pose. Fantastic. Now if you're folded over your front leg, just gently bring yourself up. We're just going to rock back onto our bottom. Bring our other leg forward. Just round into Baddha Konasana again. You can keep your feet quite wide in front of you if that's more comfortable. Or if your hips feel quite open, you can bring your heels quite close into the groin. So just take a moment with your breath. Allow the energy that you've awoken just to move around the body, just feel it moving around. gently bring your knees together. Okay. And we're just going to roll on back down, just gently. And keep your knees to your chest. Just gently massage out your back if that feels nice. And take your knees in circles in one direction. You can take them back round in the other direction. Whatever feels the best for you. Then we're going to bring our arms out in cactus arms on the floor. So if that's comfortable for you to keep your elbows in line with your shoulders, that's great. Really open up that chest area. We're just going to keep our legs in a right angle. Okay, and then just let them drop over to one side. Feel that gentle twist, just massaging your spine. Just take a couple of breaths here. Okay, so engage your bandhas. As you breathe in, take your knees back to center. And as we breathe out, gently lower them over to the other side. If your arms are not comfortable in this cactus position, so your shoulders are quite tight, that's fine. You can just have your arms down by the side. Don't worry about where your knees fall to. Engage your bandhas, bring those knees back to center, plant your feet on the floor. So you can either pop your arms down by your side, or if you're liking the feeling of being open and letting your heart be open, you can keep your arms in cactus arms. You can bring the soles of your feet together and your knees open, and lie in a reclined Baddha. Or you can just let your legs extend out in front of you in a more typical Shavasana. Or you can even bring your knees up to take pressure off your lower back. Gently close your eyes. And just breathe. And feel where you are. Just observe the emotions that have arisen during this practice today. Don't judge. Don't try and hold on to them. Just notice with curiosity what's happening within your body. As you gently just breathe, and lie here and rest for just a few moments. I just want to read a poem to you. Let go of the ways you thought life would unfold. The holding of plans or dreams or expectations. Let it all go. Save your strength to swim with the tide. The choice to fight what is here before you now will only result in struggle, fear, and desperate attempts to flee from the very energy you long for. Let go. Let it all go. Flow with the grace that washes through your days, whether you receive it gently or with all your quills raised to defend against invaders. Take this on faith. The mind may never find the explanations it seeks, but you will move forward nonetheless. Let go, and the wave's crest will carry you to unknown shores beyond your wildest dreams or destinations. Let it all go, find the place of rest and peace and certain transformation. So now, I now invite you just to rest here for a bit longer, if you'd like. And I hope that we found this practice today useful in identifying what you want to let go of around this full moon time. Thank you everyone for sharing your practice with me today. Take care.